बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ उज़ैर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू फिज़िक्स क्लास 8। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 2 काइनेमैटिक्स एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ आवर डिस्कशन इज़ ग्राफिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ मोशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी मस्ट revise what we have learned in the previous lectures. In the previous lecture we talked about terms associated with motion. The first one was position, the second was distance, third was displacement, fourth was speed, velocity and acceleration. Now in today's lecture we are going to talk about graphical analysis of motion, and before we begin our lecture we must have a clear understanding of some important concepts. First of all, what is an independent quantity? A quantity that does not depend on any other quantity or quantities is called an independent quantity. In our everyday life, time is an example of an independent quantity. In some books, authors have described an independent quantity as a variable or quantity that can be changed by the experimenter. Next is dependent quantities. A physical quantity that depends on an other quantity or quantities for its value is called a dependent quantity. Next is graph. A graph is a physical visual relation between an independent quantity and a dependent quantity. We may show more than two quantities at a time. Next is x-axis and y-axis. The line running out of paper on the right and left side of the book or the paper, or if you are sitting in front of the chair in front of your paper, the line that runs out on the right and left of yourself is called x-axis, and the line that runs out on towards the top and bottom of the page is called y-axis. Having said that, now let us discuss distance time graph. Here time is an independent quantity and distance is a dependent quantity. So time will be plotted on x-axis, whereas distance will be plotted on the y-axis. As you can see, figure 2.18 distance time graph, when the object is at rest. As you can see, this arrow that is showing intervals of 5 units and the unit of time is seconds, so therefore it shows value changing from 0 to 5, 5 to 10 and 10 to 15, whereas the arrow moving upward shows an interval of 10 units, and since we are talking about distance, therefore the distance of the unit of distance is meter, therefore it is showing the unit it is showing the distance of 0 to 10 meter, 10 to 20 meter and 20 to 30 meter. As you can see that the line in the red color is showing a constant value with respect to time. This means that the object is not moving, rather the object is at rest. In figure 2.19, we are again plotting a graph between distance and time, again taking time on the x-axis and distance on the y-axis. But this time you see that the value of distance is increasing from 0 to 40. This means that at time 0, the distance was 0, and as the time was moving, or as the stopwatch started, the body started to move with constant speed. During every 5 second interval, the body covered a distance of 10 meters. Next is object moving with variable speed. As you can see in figure 2.20, again this is distance time graph, but this time it is showing a curved line. That means that the object was not moving with a constant speed, rather with a variable speed. It was sometime it was constant, sometimes it was increasing, and sometime it was decreasing. It was not moving with constant speed. Therefore, the graph or the line showing the value of distance with respect to time is a curved line. Next, we move on to our next topic, that is speed time graph. As you can see, figure 2.22, speed time graph. Here we are taking time on the x-axis and speed on the y-axis. The unit of time is second and the unit of speed is meter per second. This figure is showing that the value of speed is constant, that is 4 meter per second. There is no change in the speed of the object with respect to time, that is, the object is moving with a constant speed. Then, object moving with uniformly changing speed, uniform acceleration. As you can see in figure 2.23, the speed time graph shows the constant uniformly changing speed of the object. That is, it is a straight line. And it shows that during every interval of 5 seconds, the body was moving with uniformly changing speed. The slope of the graph gives uniform acceleration. Next is distance traveled by a moving object. The area under a speed time graph represents the distance traveled by the object. If the motion is uniform, then the area can be calculated using appropriate formula for geometrical shapes represented by the graph. Now, at this point, we must be clear about what is a formula. A formula is a relationship between three or more quantities, and it may involve any mathematical operation, not necessary that it make that it contains a addition or subtraction operation. Rather, it can contain any mathematical operation, and it can contain even two or three mathematical operations at the same time. So our next topic is equations of motion. There are three basic equations of motion for bodies moving with uniform acceleration. These equations relate initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, time and distance covered by moving object. To simplify the derivation of these equations, we assume that the object is that the motion is along a straight line. Hence, we consider only the magnitude of displacement, velocities and acceleration. Why do we need to make this assumption? Because we have already said that displacement, velocity and acceleration are vector quantities. They have a direction attached to themselves. Therefore, in order to make it simpler, we assume that the motion is along a straight line. Therefore, there is no change in direction. So we need to focus only on the values or the magnitudes of displacement, velocity and acceleration. Consider a body moving with initial velocity vi in a straight line with uniform acceleration a. Its velocity becomes vf after time t. The motion of the body is described by the speed time graph as shown in figure 2.26. By line AB, the slope of the line AB is acceleration A. The total distance covered by the body is shown by the shaded area under the line AB. Equation of motion can be obtained easily from this graph. Our first equation of motion relates in final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and time. Therefore, in order to derive the first equation of motion, we assume that the motion is along a straight line and that the object is moving with uniform acceleration, and we are taking time along x-axis and we are taking speed along y-axis. Speed time graph for the motion of a body is shown in figure 2.26. Slope of the line AB gives the acceleration of the body. Slope of the line is giving you acceleration of the body. And how to calculate the slope of the line AB? The slope of the line is equal to acceleration, and that is calculated by the formula BC divided by AC. Now, what is BC? BC is perpendicular distance between the final point and what is A, the initial point from where the object started its motion. Now, as you can see in the figure, that BC, the distance between point B and C, is given by BD minus CD. The total distance from point D to B the distance is subtracted from the total distance. The distance is subtracted. The total distance between point B and D is BD, and the distance between C and D is subtracted so that we get the value of BC. And AC, what is AC? The line running parallel to x-axis, that is equal to OD. Now BD, the value of BD is the final velocity, and the value of CD is initial velocity, and the value of OD is equal to time. Therefore, A equals VF minus VI divided by time. VF final velocity, VI initial velocity divided by time taken to attain that final velocity. Or manipulating, we can get vf minus vi equals 80. Again, with some algebraic manipulation, we get vf equals vi plus 80. From the same graph, we get the second equation of motion. That second equation of motion relates the total distance covered by the object with the initial velocity and time and acceleration. Therefore, the total distance is given by S and it is the area of rectangle OACD plus the area of triangle ABC. Area of rectangle is given by OA multiplied by OD, that is length into width. And what is the value of length? That is VI. And what is the value of width? That is time taken. And area of triangle is given by half into AC multiplied by BC. What is AC? The width, base, the length of the base of the triangle, and BC is the height of the triangle ABC. Therefore, AC equals time and BC equals acceleration multiplied by time. Summing up, the total area of rectangle and triangle, we get the total area of OABD. Now, summing up, total area is equal to S, that is we are denoting the total area by S, and the value of area of triangle is VI into T, that is initial velocity multiplied by time, plus half of the area of triangle, that is half 1 over 2 multiplied by time into acceleration multiplied by time. Therefore, we get S is equal to VIT plus half AT square. That is the second equation of motion. From the same graph, we get the third equation of motion. That third equation of motion relates final velocity, initial velocity, and acceleration and time, acceleration and distance to each other. Therefore, again in this figure 2.26, the speed time graph, the total distance traveled by a body is given by the total area OABD under the graph. Total area S equals OA plus BD divided by 2 multiplied by OD. Now, what is OA? OA is the initial velocity, and what is BD? The final velocity multiplied by OD, that is the time taken. But that is OA plus BD divided by 2, that is it is divided, the sum is divided by 2 and then multiplied by the value of time taken. Therefore, after algebraic manipulation, we get 2S equals OA plus BD multiplied by OD. Multiplying both sides by BC over OD, we get 2S multiplied by BC over OD equals OA plus BD multiplied by OD multiplied by BC over OD. Simplifying the equation, we get 2S multiplied by BC over OD equals OA plus BD multiplied by BC. Putting the value of BC, OD, OA and BD, we get 2S multiplied by A equals VF plus VI multiplied by VF minus VI, that is 2 times acceleration multiplied by distance or displacement, gives us the difference of square of final velocity and the square of initial velocity. I hope things have been easy for you, and I hope to make them more easy for you. Hope to see you soon with my next lecture next week. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.